Welcome to this short introduction to job history in SERTICA. My name is Rasmus Hansen. I'm the head of the project department at Rina Digital Solutions. Today, I'll try to show you how you can improve your use of SERTICA and hopefully optimize your business. Job history in SERTICA is a registration of a task that has been completed. This means that whenever you carry out work, you register it as job history inside SERTICA. The process can be started either from a scheduled job that you have in your job list, or it can be done directly on a piece of equipment where you've done some work without a predefined job and you just want to register the work done. Let's have a look at how you register job history when you have a scheduled job that needs to be completed. First, I'll go to my job list, and the job list is found down here in the bottom, and I press the button and it opens up my job list, and I can see the jobs that are meant to be carried out. The red ones are overdue, so I should probably look at those. I'll take the main engine 3 overhaul here, and you can see that I have some job details, I have some registered spare parts that needs to be used when we do the job, and there's also an attached document, a manual in this case. Now, the first step in creating job history could be that you want to activate the job inside SERTICA, meaning that you tell the system that now the job has been started. So I press the activate job button in the top, and it asks me if I want to print out a job card. In this case, I want to do this, so I say yes, and it opens up this small dialog where I can choose if I want to print to a printer or open on screen my job card, and also let me either print or open up the attached documentation. In this case, it's the manual. If I select to open both, like so, and say print open, the system will generate a work order and also open the manual as you see here, so I can have a look at it, read what I need to do. I'll close this again. It also brings up the job card that contains the details of the job that needs to be carried out. This can be printed and then brought to the piece of machinery that needs to be worked on. Now that is the first step, and as you can see here in the job list, as soon as I've activated my job, it turns green. A green is an indication that a job has been started but not yet completed. I go out, I do my work, and then come back to the system and I want to register that the job has been completed. So I select the job from my job list and then I say update job history. This lets me fill in the details of the work actually carried out. So I can put on a date. Let's say I did it today. All work done according to manual, like so. I say next. It asks me if I used or want to register any resources, meaning hours, if I've used any spare parts I wish to register, if there's any documents I want to attach, and if I want to register any downtime for the piece of equipment. I do my selection like this and press next. And the next step is then to register the resources used, meaning the hours. In this case, I'm working as the chief engineer, and I can then register the amount of hours I've used. There was an estimate on the job of 2 hours, but I can amend this to say I only spent 1 on this. I say next. Then the next thing is the spare parts. In this case, I can register the spare parts used. It's also possible here to link to the stock part of SERTICA, where spare parts can automatically be drawn from the stock when they are registered as used on the job history. In this case, the system estimates that I will spend 4 of one part and 5 of another. I can amend this here, saying I only use 3 of these bolts, and that is okay, and I press next. The last step here is if I want to add any documentation. It might be that I took a picture of the work done. It might be that I have some kind of other documentation that I want to attach to this job history. In this case, I have nothing, so I just press next. The last step in the wizard is to register if the job should be kept open, meaning if I'm not done yet, I can keep it open for tomorrow, or I can mark it as being finalized, meaning that the job has been carried out and no further work is needed. In this case, I'll choose to finalize the job and press finish. Now this means that the job has now been registered as completed. You can see that now it is turned into the black color and it got a new next date here, the next due date in 5 years time, because this is a 5-year job that I'm doing. As soon as I refresh my job list, the job will disappear from here and come up again in 5 years. If I want to go to my job in the tree structure, I now have a registration of the actual job carried out. So under my main engine number 3, under my overhaul job, I can now expand this. It shows me a job history folder. I can expand that as well. There's a job done in 2022, and I can expand that further to see the items used or the spare parts used and the hours used. So this way you have the complete history of the work carried out directly in your tree structure. The process we've been through here, now this is done in SERTICA, but it can also be done using our mobile app. We'll make another video on that. Now, if you want to carry out a job that is not registered in the system yet, it might be that you have a breakdown on a piece of machinery and you fix it as quickly as possible, and you just want to register that you've done the work, but you don't want to predefine a job and so on. Then you actually have the option of opening up the piece of equipment here, and then you can create a job history directly on the piece of equipment without a predefined job. When you're on the piece of machinery, you have some buttons in the top here where you can actually create a job history directly. It can either be a job history for work done, maybe you painted the machine or something like that, or it could also be a registration of a defect job history, meaning that if you had a breakdown or something broke, you can register that you fixed it. The process is more or less the same. The job history will just be marked as a defect job history if you use this button. Other than that, the flow is the same. So when I press the button, it starts up the job history screen here where I can enter my remarks, I can register items and so on, and then complete my job. In this case, I won't do it. But it's very important to understand that you don't need a predefined job to actually register job history on a piece of equipment. That's it for now. I hope you got something out of it. Bye.
If you'd like to learn more about SERTICA and our modules, visit our website.